and welcome to this week's episode of Fight Factory Weekly with me, your host, the pretty boy, Peter Payne, the freshly trimmed pretty boy, Peter Payne. And when I told the women of Fight Factory Wrestling that I was gonna get a haircut, they said, pretty boy, are you sure you know what you're doing? And then when I showed them the finished results, they said, oh yes, you know exactly what you're doing. Particularly Eliza Rue, who said the words, wow, you're hot, hubba, hubba, hubba. Her words, definitely not mine. Now, this show isn't just about my wonderful hair, it's about the non-stop action from Fight Factory Wrestling. So let's see what's coming up on today's episode. Today's show will feature the 12 bouts of Christmas. Coming up, we will see the confrontation surrounding the Academy Championship featuring a number of LFFW Academy stars. And we will see a one-on-one contest featuring two fan favourites. It's Major Air taking on the returning Paul Malan. So let's take you to that confrontation surrounding the Academy Championship. Miss Rebecca's in the ring, addressing the crowd, interrupted rudely by my best mate, Will Wilde, who is sore about losing the Academy Championship to Tommy Ryder. Did someone say Tommy Ryder? Because out he comes to get face to face with Will Wilde. Then out of nowhere, the sinister Aiden Drake comes out to stake his claim for the Academy Championship. You will not believe what happens next. Let's take a look.
Will Wilde there was looking for a rematch with Tommy Ryder for the Academy Championship. And now, out of nowhere, Joey Osborne, and there he is, there's Joey Osborne, there is the Fight Factory Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. What on earth is he doing here at this moment in time at 12 Bouts of Christmas? Please tell me he's not got his sights set on the Academy Championship as well. Although I must be honest, with his ego, I could expect it. Still don't quite get it, I just don't understand what he's doing out here. Will Wilde's shoulder was obviously injured in that Academy Scramble match, and that's probably the reason why I ended up losing the Academy Championship in the first place. There seems to be some support tonight here at 12 Bouts with Joey Osborne.
You've expected me to come out here and say something horrible, haven't you?
Yes!
You all have, haven't you? But you are all wrong. Because it's Christmas, isn't it? It's the season of giving and the season of goodwill. Am I right? So maybe I should give a present to someone in Eliza Rue is not here, and neither since you all think I'm a cheat, how about if we make it a little bit more interesting? If I get counted out, if I get disqualified, Tommy Ryder is the new champion.
Am I getting this right? Is Joey Osborne rescinding his championship advantage in this challenge to Tommy Ryder for the Fight Factory Wrestling Heavyweight Championship?
So that means that the only way that I can beat you is by making you tap like a bitch that you are. Pinning your shoulders to this canvas, 1, 2, 3. Or just knocking you the F out.
Wow.
To be a 15-year-old undisputed champion is something that, well, I have to take to the main event tonight. Tommy Ryder, Academy champion, versus Joey Osborne, the heavyweight champion, for that beautiful title you've got there.
Wow, what a main event here tonight at 12 bouts. I mean, who would have thought it?
Just a word of warning, even if you manage to get past that, and you will not get past Joey Osborne,
get some doubt.
Your story is not over.
I told you wouldn't believe it. Joey Osborne, the FFW heavyweight champion, interrupting everybody and challenging Tommy Ryder for a title match. Now, even if Tommy Ryder makes it through this match, which we will feature today as our main event, he is still a massive target for all of the Academy wrestlers who want a piece of the Academy Championship. Now we're gonna take you to that one-on-one match I promised you. It's Major Air versus the returning Paul Malan. I can't wait to see this one. Let's throw it to Nick Raven at ringside and see how it all unfolded.
And the bell rings and we're on the way. Major Air versus Paul Malan here at Birchwood's 12 Bouts of Christmas. And there, the obligatory handshake at the beginning of this matchup. Both these guys, fan favourites, and both of these looking to go and really prove themselves today at 12 Bouts of Christmas. The lock up there, Major Air and Paul Malan. Paul Malan on top early on. Rushes Major Air into the corner, and a clean break it would appear. Major Air, obviously, last time he performed at Lincoln Fight Factory Wrestling, it was our Body Slams to Kansas show just a couple of months ago. And Paul Malan, a well-known wrestler from Nottingham, very close by and so beloved to the Lincoln crowd. They have a swap round there though with Major Air, and again the clean break out the corner with a collar elbow tie-up. Very slow pace this matchup to begin. Now, locks up again. Now, this time, Paul Malan takes the arm, takes the left arm of Major, and that wrist lock now, wringing that wrist. Putting pressure as Major, they're trying to look for an escape, but every time he tries to look for something, straight away with that wrist lock, putting the pressure on. But look at that, a reversal there by Major Air. Major Air now, wrist lock of his own. Going through though with Paul Malan and into the hammerlock from behind. Malan, tight hammerlock there. Major Air looking for his escape. Paul Malan trying to get the crowd into this. It's Major Air now. Look at that for an escape though. Go behind into the waist lock. Paul Malan in trouble. No, maybe not. Swap around again. Malan now, headlock takedown. Tight headlock takedown there by Malan. Major Air is not far from the ropes, it has to be said, but he's looking for work his way back up to a vertical base and escaping that way. Off the ropes, Malan comes back off and a big shoulder check there by Malan. Look at that though, ducks down though, Major Air, and once again with a headlock takedown, Paul Malan in control, side control in the middle of the ring. You can hear Paul Malan there trying to get the crowd into this matchup. Now, Major Air working his way back up to a vertical base out there. Headlock sending Malan off the ropes. Ducks down, but again, that shoulder check of Paul Malan. Now, Major Air goes to sleep. Hops over. Look looking for the hip toss there, but no, reverse by Paul Malin. And Paul Malin there with a beautiful hip toss in the middle of the ring. And Paul Malin now offering the handshake again. It's taken a major air. A lot of respect shown between these two competitors, and it's nice to see right here today at Fight Factory Wrestling at the Birchwood Leisure Centre. Crowd becoming a bit more lively now, and again the lockup, Major Air, Paul Malin, and now Major Air's looking for something out of that lockup, takes a wrist of his own, looking to put the pressure on the wrist and shoulder, but again Paul Malin with that reversal, breaking the grip there on the wrist. Now Paul Malin on side headlock, goes down to one knee. Major Air was looking for that escape there, manages to find his way out, and now turns it to a hammerlock of his own. And Paul Malin looking for an escape, but back elbow there. I'm not quite sure that was in keeping with the respect that's been shown so far in this matchup. Now sends him into the corner. Major Air vaults over off second rope with a back elbow there to Paul Malin. And now big drop kick by Major Air. Paul Malin is down. And Major Air now, with a little bit of a spark, runs at Paul Malin, but Paul Malin just sidesteps and helps to send Major Air over the top rope and out of the ring. And look at that down there, Major Air really, really hurting after taking that tumble to the outside. Well, Major Air actually does really look hurt on the outside. Referee's checking. But Major Air, though, saying it was all right and not wanting to give up in this contest. Referee now putting a count on Major Air. And Major Air making his way back into the ring. Now Paul Malin quickly back onto Major Air. A big fist there. Big shot by Malin. Picks him up. A big forearm there. Clubbing blow to the back of Major Air. Now takes the arm, whips off the ropes, looking for a clothesline, hits a massive lariat there. Paul Malin with the lariat, lateral press, cover, but only gets a one count. Malin, headmare takeover, and goes into a chin lock now. Tight chin lock by Malin, and Major Air there trying to get the crowd back onto his side, trying to find an escape. He's making his way back up, but Malin transitioned the chin, and now Major Air there with elbows to the breadbasket looking for the escape. Going off the rope, head of steam, ducks the clothesline, goes over sunset flip, catches him, one, two, only gets a two count though off the sunset flip, and a big back elbow there by Paul Malin. Major Air crash landing there after that big elbow. And now Malin, headmare takeover again, and back to that chin lock. Major Air once again trying to get the crowd back into this, trying to feed off the crowd, get some energy to escape that chin lock, making his way back up now. Big elbow to the bread basket. And shot there by Major Air, but look at that double chop, and Malin looking for that cutter he's used to finish, but no, Major Air sends him off the ropes, a massive discus forearm by Major Air, pressing the reset button, if you will. Now look at that, Major Air feeding again off the crowd, making his way back up to his feet. Malin, forearm, Major Air returns in kind. Big shot by Malin. Major Air, a European uppercut. And Paul Malin there, a European uppercut of his own. Now forearms there, but Major Air, forearms are plenty. Off of the ropes, looking for something. Ducks the clothesline, off the ropes again. Goes for a switch round, waist lock, looking for the roll up, roll up, roll up. One, two, but no, no. Schoolboy, schoolboy by Paul Malin. Two, oh, he got the free count. Stole one with that schoolboy out of nowhere.
Paul Malin.
of the victory there in what was a very closely contested match up there. Could have went either way. And it was just that the ring presence there. Paul Malin going straight for that schoolboy after kicking out of that roll-up by Major Air. And look at the handshake there between the two. Closely fought contest there, but your winner tonight is Paul Malin.
Paul Malin kicking out of the sunset flip and then instantly rolling up Major Air for the cheeky 1-2-3. But the handshake at the end showing that it is all in the spirit of competition. Now let's take you to our main event. We showed you earlier that Joey Osborne was willing to put his FFW Heavyweight Championship on the line against the Academy champion, Tommy Ryder. It's gonna be an absolute firecracker. It's champion versus champion. It's the Rising Star versus the FFW Heavyweight Champion. Let's throw it to Nick Raven at ringside and see how it all unfolded.
And I'll tell you something right now, ladies and gentlemen. Can you believe what we are about to see here tonight? 12 Bouts of Christmas. It is a championship, heavyweight championship match. And there is the challenger of all people. He is the Lincoln Fight Factory Wrestling Academy's champion. He is the Rising Star, Tommy Ryder. Who would have thought it? Who would have thought coming into this that this opportunity would present itself to that young man? 15 years of age, that's all. And tonight, a shot at the heavyweight championship, a shot at Joey Osborne. Such a huge opportunity. Such pressure as well on the shoulders of Tommy Ryder going this. And yeah, look at that exuberance there. He's up for the challenge. You can tell he just wants to get on with it. He believes in himself. He believes that he can come out of 12 Bouts of Christmas the new heavyweight champion. Of course, many a fan will remember Boiling Point. We'll remember Tommy Ryder against the House of Pain, the heavyweight House of Pain Sticks. And how close Tommy Ryder was to pulling off an upset on that occasion. And you've got to wonder, could this time round the upset actually happen against this man? The Fight Factory Wrestling Heavyweight Champion from Norwich. He is Joey Osborne. He laid out the challenge earlier on tonight. He prefixed it with the saying, Merry Christmas. And ended with a very, very prominent statement. Joey Osborne. He's an arrogant champion. He's many a thing. But no matter what you say, what adjective or verb you may want to use, he is the heavyweight champion. As there, Tommy Ryder, almost like saluting Joey with his own belt, the Academy belt. It is going to be champion versus champion tonight. But that man's belt right there, we apologise for the hand signal there. That man's belt right there, the heavyweight championship, is going to be on the line. And the belt will change hands on a disqualification or a count out. No championship advantage in this matchup. Look at that sight there. Both champions.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your 12 Bouts of Christmas main event for the Lincoln Fight Factory Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. Standing in the corner to my left, the challenger. He weighs in this afternoon at 135 pounds. Hailing from northeast Lincolnshire, he is your current Lincoln Fight Factory Wrestling Academy champion, the Rising Star, Tommy Ryder!
certainly no fear
and
on that face there.
To my right, he weighs in at 220 pounds. Coming to us from Norwich, he is your current defending.
Well, there seems to be a Norwich contingency in the crowd tonight.
He is your current reigning and defending Lincoln Fight Factory Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, Joey Osborne!
The champion. Referee. Taking the belt. The belt's on the line. The Fight Factory Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. And here we go. This matchup is underway. And I can't believe I'm saying it even still. Tommy Ryder against Joey Osborne for the heavyweight championship. And Tommy Ryder there looking, well, I think he was looking for some sort of cheap shot from behind, not quite his style, but he knows he's the underdog in this matchup. You can just bet yourself that he is going to be taking any opportunity he gets, like he's taking the opportunity tonight in just even accepting this matchup, actually this matchup taking place. Tommy Ryder, Joey Osborne going for the lockup again there, but Joey Osborne missing as Tommy Ryder ducks under, and the confidence to taunt Joey Osborne there by Tommy Ryder. You can just tell that he's just saying, I'm not afraid of you, I'm not intimidated, this matchup is going to happen and I am going to take this heavyweight championship off of you. Lock up again, goes for lock up, but look at that, Joey Osborne catching a four way for headlock there, throw it to the corner, but no, Tommy Ryder there manages to escape outside the ring, switch round on the outside, and Tommy Ryder there, short drop kick to Joey Osborne on the outside, stuns Joey Osborne there, and Tommy Ryder off the apron there, a rolling senton. Does it look like there's any fear in that face of Tommy Ryder? I think not. Ryder on the outside, looking to drive the head of Joey Osborne into the apron, but no, and Joey Osborne reverses and drives the cranium of the Rising Star into the steel of the ring apron. Tommy Ryder's seen stars after that. Now, Joey Osborne on the advantage, double chop there to the throat of Tommy Ryder. Now, Osborne sends him off the ropes, but no, switch around. Tommy Ryder trying to reverse there. Look at that, stamping on the floor of Joey Osborne. Now, ducks under, goes over. Osborne manages to stop himself. Now, switch around there. But look at that, though. That was a back kick there by Tommy Ryder catching Joey Osborne. That was a beaut. And now, seated drop kick. A Ryder special. Well, Tommy Ryder looking to finish early here, looking for that tornado DDT. Not getting it though on this occasion. And now Osborne managing to just dump Tommy Ryder with that big back body drop. Now Osborne trying to take advantage there. Big kick. Again, knocking the stars straight out of Tommy Ryder. Joey Osborne now looking to set something up there. Christ almighty, what a kick to the back there. That could have broke the spine of Tommy Ryder. And now Joey Osborne grabbing the hair of Tommy Ryder, lifting back onto a vertical base, picking him up. And a huge scoop slam there. Just the spine again of Tommy Ryder crashing hard onto the canvas. And again, aiming at that back there, Joey Osborne with a short drop kick. Hook of the leg, but only gets a two count though. Tommy Ryder showing some spunk and kicking out to that pinfall attempt. Joey Osborne there taking his time, but you can bet your bottom dollar he is still in control. Now cinches up Tommy Ryder, looking for a vertical suplex. He's got the stall. Big vertical hanging suplex there onto Tommy Ryder. Joey Osborne, lateral press, two, only gets a two count though on this occasion. Joey Osborne still in control, stalking Tommy Ryder with that trademark, just the way he stalks. And look at that though, now just choking Tommy Ryder over that second rope, not legal. He's got to be careful, because like I say, that title will change hands on a disqualification. Now, Joey Osborne, what's it? Jeez! That is just disrespectful. Just slapping the taste out of the mouth of Tommy Ryder. Now, Joey Osborne back into the ring. Tommy Ryder's stunned. Tommy Ryder doesn't quite know where he is. Now, Osborne off the ropes. Big back elbow there by Joey Osborne, sending Tommy Ryder once again crashing to the canvas. Now, lateral press, two, only a two count. Tommy Ryder managed to kick out, and now trying to get the crowd to give him a second wind, lift his spirits. But look at that there again, Osborne straight back onto his feet, stalking Tommy Ryder, taking his time. Big headbutt. Even that stunned Joey Osborne himself, the force and velocity behind that headbutt. Joey Osborne there doing his best Russell Crowe impression. Now, corner to corner. Ryder stunned in the corner. Joey Osborne runs through, follows through even, but no, Tommy Ryder gets the boots up, and again. Now, Ryder off the second rope. Can he get through it to come back? That big sit-down drop kick there off the second rope. Tommy Ryder, hook of the leg. Could it be a new champion? No. Only a two count there by Tommy Ryder. Now, off the ropes, looking, look at that there, sidewinder. Hook of the leg again. Could this be new champions? Oh, that was close. Tommy Ryder, only a quarter of a second away there, to becoming the new Fight Factory Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. Yes, I did say that once again. Now, Joey Osborne reverses the Irish whip into the corner. Tommy Ryder looking to bolt over there, but no, Joey Osborne caught him. Now, but look at that, Tommy Ryder there, taking advantage of that turn to a head scissors. Now, Joey Osborne's on the ropes. Tommy Ryder looking to take advantage. Whips Joey Osborne off the ropes. Ducks the clothesline, ducks the back elbow. Now, Tommy Ryder bolts over Joey Osborne. So he went for the back body drop, but no. Back elbow again, miss. And that time there, though, Joey Osborne managing just to use his knee, that knee lift, to stop the motion of Tommy Ryder, and that big elbow there to the back of Tommy Ryder's head. Joey Osborne just staring into the eyes there. Tommy Ryder saying, you can't beat me. There's a big shot there though, but no. Tommy Ryder ducks under again. Drop kick there by Tommy Ryder. He's keeping in this. Now Tommy Ryder hook of the leg. Two. No. Again, another near fall there for Tommy Ryder. And every near fall, you start to believe, you start to think, the rising star could possibly do this here tonight at 12 bouts. Tommy Ryder again off the ropes. Joey Osborne sends him with the momentum. Now, what's that? Pop up, sit out, powerbomb. That's it. Joey retains, but oh no. How did Tommy Ryder kick out of that? And the crowd taunting Joey Osborne, saying it was only a two. And now making their feelings known to Joey Osborne. Seriously though, how did Tommy Ryder kick out of that sit-out powerbomb? I'm lost for words. But now, Torada desperately trying to get to a vertical base. Slow, sluggish. Joey Osborne's going for it again at the seam. Looking to finish it off here, but no, overshoots Tommy Ryder, managing to keep his balance as such. That drop kick there by Tommy Ryder. Now Tommy Ryder, could he hit it? Could this be it? Tornado DDT, yes! Tornado DDT! Can that be it? No, Tommy Ryder looking to put way more. Big side kick there to the side of the cranium of Joey Osborne. And now Tommy Ryder looking to go high risk. High risk, hit or miss, but the championship is on the line. You've got to believe he's going to go all out. And oh, that was a beautiful elbow off the top rope. Hook of the leg, two, and oh, no. Osborne kicks out of that beautiful elbow off the top of Paige out of the Zebra Kid there. And now, Tommy Ryder trying to keep the momentum going. Looking once more. Looking for a super kick, but no. Cat caught there, but Joey Osborne picks him up into a powerbomb. Powerbomb there, but look at again. And no, that's another sit-down powerbomb. That's got to be it. Sure it is. Joey Osborne retains.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner.
It took two sugar dips there, excuse the expression. Two power bombs, two sit-out power bombs, and that combination power bomb at the end. Joey Osborne retains. But what an effort, though, by the rising star, Tommy Ryder. You've got to wonder what's going through the mind of Joey Osborne at the moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, one last Christmas present for you. I've just got off the phone to Will Wilde's doctor. He's now cleared to perform. So, Will Wilde, have yourself a title match now. Merry Christmas, Ryder.
You must be kidding me. I mean, Tommy Ryder's just gone through a hell of a match against the heavyweight champion there, Joey Osborne. And Manson out of nowhere just saying he's cleared, and they're calling for the bell. This is an official Academy title match. After Tommy Ryder's going to be screwed here as Will Wilde gets, no! Will Wilde only gets a two count, that massive elbow. Now Will Wilde looking for something here. That sit out there, angel's wings almost. And again, hooker leg, this is it. New champ. No! Tommy Ryder kicks it out, and I have no idea how, after such a hellacious contest with Joey Osborne, literally minute or two ago. Wilde looking to finish him off, put Tommy Ryder away. Go for that elbow again. No, Tommy Ryder scoots under. Look, out of nowhere, that cutter off the second rope. Can that do it? And look at that! Tommy Ryder!
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner and still Lincoln Fight Factory Wrestling Academy Champion, the Rising Star, Tommy Ryder!
Barely able to keep Will Wilde down after that cut off the second. A last dish, last, what, fourth, fifth, sixth win there after it was about to be screwed. And Will Wilde, look at that in the middle of the ring. Will Wilde can't believe it. Tommy Ryder can't believe what's just happened. And look at that expression there. I'll tell you something, this rivalry is not going to be over for a long time yet. Look at that though, look at that face, it's real wild there. You don't need to hear the words there, the expression says everything. You just get the feeling this rivalry is going to continue for a long time yet.
An impassioned performance from the rising star, Tommy Ryder. Would you expect anything less? Of course you wouldn't. Three power bombs, keeping the Academy champion down. Joey Osborne getting the 1-2-3, retaining his FFW Heavyweight Championship. And then what about that dastardly Shane the Man Manson coming out, declaring Will Wilde physically fit and making a match for the Academy Championship there and then, Will Wilde versus the Rising Star. You think it's all over for Tommy Ryder, but out of nowhere, he hits the springboard stunner and keeps Will Wilde down for the 1-2-3. That rivalry, clearly far from over, and any developments you will see right here on Fight Factory Weekly. Now, if you want to see some FFW action live, on the 28th of February, we present Overdrive at the Birchwood Leisure Centre. Now, if you want tickets, you know what to do. Simply visit www.linkswrestling.co.uk or go to the venue itself and pick up your tickets. Well, this has been another roller coaster of a show. This has been Fight Factory Weekly. I've been the pretty boy Peter Payne. You've been beautiful. I've been beautiful. I'll see you next week.
Today we're born somehow.
Game time!